Okay. We have a straight. We can dig for a better flush. One more time, better diamonds. Could go for a straight with either a nine or an ace. We should go for the diamonds. Bummer. All right, start over. Uncommon tag, huge. Let's do it. ELO chess wants to know, what is the worst deck on gold stake aside from black deck? I think Nebula deck's kind of hard. I think the thing that makes Nebula deck difficult is the telescope doesn't really help you in the early game. So the early game can be kind of a struggle. Just like the black deck. I don't hate this, but we already did this. Cardomancer, that helps us do aces. Buffoon pack. We can take a credit card. All right. All right, Grimbo, let's go. It's you and me, Grimbo. Now I just need splash. Okay, here's the move. We need to draw kings. Okay, kings. Four chips on my rubber ducky. Bummer. We're in debt. It's okay, it'll be fine. Just go next. Temperance? Look. I'm not even gonna use it now. I didn't draw my kings. I'm sad. Oh well. Ship it? Mars, Sun. I think we just go next. Now I will use Temperance to make room. CeCe is excited to see the duck synergies with the next patch because the patch allows the duck to absorb bonus cards and stone cards. That's so sick. Could take a death card, could take a spectral pack. I think no on justice. We can light them up. We have objectively less aces than before. Is this live? Wait, is it ever not live? Yeah, it's live. I'm here. Hello, hi, it's me. I'm the guy. I'm the problem, it's me. Let's go next. ELO chess wants to know, do I think that the old gold stake was harder than the new gold stake? I think the old gold stake was easier, actually. Well, yeah. What was different? Instead of having rental jokers, it was minus one hand size. Booster packs were more expensive. Not just more expensive, but the prices increased every ante. Booster packs cost more. I think at the time that I played the old gold stake, I wasn't as good at the game as I am now. And then so it seemed more difficult, but maybe it wasn't objectively that difficult. It was just boring. It was just too linear, too restrictive. Let's go Aces of Hearts. Hermit for 20 bucks. Yeah, so the thing about the old gold stake was, if you have minus one hand size, in addition, by the way, oh, it's not here, but the, you know, the blue stake is minus one discard, and in addition to this, it was also minus one hand size on the gold stake, so you really couldn't just play any hands at all. So it was just spam high cards, spam pairs. And without rental jokers and without perishable jokers, you just get the same jokers every time and then keep them forever, right? So every run you would just build the same build because there was no punishment on your jokers. And the booster packs, every ante they would cost more. So ante 2, you're paying $5 for a booster pack. Then you're paying $6, $7. You get to the end of the run, you're paying $14 for a booster pack. And so you just wouldn't buy booster packs. And if you can't buy booster packs, you can't build your deck. If you can't build your deck, you can't play hands. Or at least not any interesting hands. We could take a star and make diamonds. And then that makes it easier to feed the ducky. Yeah, I'm kind of into that. Go next. Neptune and Mercury. Yeah, I guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Diamonds for rough gem. You know, Honokane, I was thinking exactly the same thing. That's crazy. Could take fortune teller. Do we have the interest voucher? We do. We do have the seed money. We can take an ace of diamonds. You know, here with the ducky, we can add a bunch of cards to our deck, and then that'll give us more material to feed the ducky. Credit card useless right now? Yeah, but we don't really have a replacement for it until now, is why I didn't care about replacing it. Take a star. I think as far as like designing new stake ideas or whatever, it's pretty easy to just make it difficult, like so difficult that it's impossible. It's really tough to make it a little bit more difficult but still possible. That's the challenge with new stake ideas. The hiker would go kind of hard here. Yeah, we got the hiker last run. The hiker did a lot of work. We got up to 200 chips on our cards. We can take strength. We don't need a square up because we've got the rubber ducky. Taking four of a kind. Temperance gives us 14 bucks. We can also spin the wheel. We can use strength on a king. Getting closer on the aces. Spin the wheel first. Hodbeak just got Completionist Plus. Finally finished all the decks. Found two souls on the erratic deck. That's cool. Were they at all useful? You know, sometimes you get the souls on the, you know, whatever deck, and then sometimes you get Kania or sometimes you get Tribble and it doesn't really fit your build. I feel obligated to ask, was it actually useful? Sorry, I saw this guy and I had a reaction. Take a Mars card here. Another ace. Go next. Is it possible to do four of a kind at the same time as doing the hologram? Let's find out. Error wants to know, what are the new jokers? Yeah, so right now we just have one new one. We've got the Rubber Ducky. Rubber Ducky is the opposite of Hiker. It steals chips from your cards. So currently the Ducky's on 68 chips. If we look at some of these aces, this one's -4. And some of these diamonds here, this five, or here's -4, here's -2. -6 on the nines. Ducky's hungry. Ducky just wants to have a little snack, a little snacky. I want to remind folks, if you didn't already know, you shouldn't feed ducks bread. Could take JJ. Is that going to be better than Grimbo? Probably. Could take Northern Lion. I don't really have room. I don't think we can get rid of anything. Aldrizzle says grapes or oats are good for ducks. That's good to know. I know what's bad for them, but I don't know what's good for them. We could go more diamonds here. They like peas? I would believe that. Do I need to make some lucky cards in order to unlock the warlock? Or we'll do it later. We'll do it later. Hierophant? Okay. Now that we got rid of Grimbo, we can actually just discard. We can actually just find aces if we want to find aces. Could play four of a kind. I want to play, so here the -2 and the -2 ace, use the Hierophant. So now it's +28 chips. We got extra chips for the ducky. Do a little snacky. Okay. I don't think I'm going to do the hack. We can take another star, take a celestial pack. We got the flush five. We could level up the flush. I don't think we need to. Hologram, we can take a blue seal or we can take another ace. Let's take the blue seal. Go next. We draw the blue seal. All we gotta do is draw aces and we can make diamonds. I can go diamonds this way. I can go here, minus two, here, minus two, go hierophant. Flush five again. It's easy. If we don't get the pocket aces, we're gonna make it common. CeCe's gonna break the rules, I'm telling. ELO chess wants to know, can you reach ante 39 without blueprint, brainstorm, or legendary jokers? You can do it without legendaries, for sure. It can be done without legendaries. You can do it without blueprints and brainstorms if you just get, what is it? Showman, and then Showman gives you copies of barons and mimes and stuff like that. Like, I think that's possible. But you do need some negative jokers, some naturally negative jokers. Does the duck eat the hierophant chips? It does eat the bonus chips. That's why we're gonna get a bunch of bonus cards just for funsies. We can make a blue steel card. We can copy it and then play the aces. Uwu, you've gotten the pocket aces to work. Man, I'm jealous. Hungman, yes. Sign me up. Do I want a glass five? So I could just take a card for the hologram, and then that way the hologram is bigger. Maybe I don't need that. Maybe I'm feeling confident without that. So let's not do it. The duck just absorbs your whole deck for free points. Yeah, it's a chip scaler. Like, castle stacks up chips, and square joker stacks up chips, but comes at a cost. What if we take the sixes? And then we get the lucky cards in the future? Think of the synergy. Go next. Fives. We can hang them. Nice. So, take the hungman here. Death. Okay, 7 and 8, we can hang him. Death, I can make another blue seal. We have enough aces. We have 9 aces, that's enough aces. That's probably enough aces. I can get more aces later. We'll make a trip to the store. We'll pick up some aces. This JJ has not really done the thing yet. In terms of, we don't have that much making the money. Seventeen cards in the deck. Throw away one of the blue ones. Let's not be greedy. Ship it. 400 Elo chest wants us to use the Lover's card because we can grow the fortune teller. That's a thing that we could do. I think we get maybe a little bit of molt from the planet cards. We can take a death card. Fortune Teller needs a buff. Fortune Teller is a relic from a bygone era. Holographic. Nah. Eternal Paradox, hello, welcome back. Been trying to do an endless run. What flavor of endless run? There's all different kinds of flavors. Wait, tell me more. Adrizzle says bygone is in like 2023. Yeah, last year. The summer alpha version of the Balatro. Eternal Paradox, trying to do the Baron and Mime combo. Don't have the patience for Idol. The Idol do be asking a lot, I gotta say. All right, I'm willing to make another five. I'm willing to make a gold ace. I could make a gold ace and then copy it, but I think the blue seal is more important. Dice doing nothing. No, dice doing nothing yet. Okay? You just gotta believe. Dice doing their absolute darndest. Doing their best. Alright, fortune teller. You're a clown. Oh. We did it. We got the magician. All right, JJ, get out of here. Well, I guess we could do judgment first. All right. The boss says no repeat hand types. Play the flush. Psychronic says the rubber ducky doesn't seem to scale well. We updated it. We changed the rubber ducky. Rubber ducky now grows by three. So if you play five cards, that's 15 chips per hand. That's a lot for just any five card hand. You compare that to the runner. The runner gives you 15 chips, but it has to be a straight. It's a little bit more complicated than that because you do have to play a five card hand, so maybe you have to play a straight in order to get the ducky to trigger on five cards, or maybe you have to play a flush. Maybe what the ducky actually says is you get 15 chips per flush, and maybe it's a little bit easier than the runner. It grows a little bit faster than the runner because it's uncommon if it's three chips per card. But then, once you've grown the ducky, once you've reached stuntman levels of chips, you could play whatever. You could play you know, I could play a pair here. And if we still had the fortune teller, it would actually do some points. I need an ace, so we discard the fives. We got the ace, let's find more fives. Two lucky cards. Extra chips for our ducky. Ooh, it's Myrtle. If we pick up Myrtle here, we can copy it. Ooh, if we take the turtle, what are we getting rid of? We can make a steel card, I guess. It's tough. I guess the sixes. Brutal. Get rid of the green haired guy. That's $5 reduce. Not the green haired guy. The sixes gives us $2 every round. Every round we play two lucky cards, that's $2. All right, go next. We need the tarot cards. Yeah, like this world card. No repeats. Bang. Chapin says the duck is adorable, but? What do you mean, but? Invisible hit the dice? Yeah. Now you're thinking with portals. Gold card is fine, or we can discard for another blue seal. Yas. The duck has 200 chips, which is almost as high as my flush five. Look at that. All right. Are you ready? Bummer. Hey, wait. We can eat the chips twice as fast. Double ducky. Hashtag double ducky. I think I want to go back in time. Raina Cruz is trying to create an instruction manual for a college class on how to get NAN inf. I wanted to use my anti-8 seed, but don't know how to do it on this particular patch. Oh yeah, because this particular patch, it's kind of an old video, right? It's kind of an old seed and then a newer, you know, now the seed doesn't work anymore. I don't know, man. I do have a video. Well, I guess what you need is you need to start with Perkeo and then Cryptid. So start there, Perkeo and Cryptid. The hologram video had a pretty good start. If you want to check out the seed from the hologram video, that's much more recent. But just kind of like, Perkeo with Cryptid is the easiest way to go. You can technically do it without Perkeo, but maybe that's the easy way to go. Let's go Lucky Ace of Hearts, or no, because it's not diamonds. I'm going to skip. gold seal jack. Yeah. Take a hermit? Oh, baby. Strength and star. We don't need the star because we already have aces of diamonds. Let's go back in time. Back in time means we get to grow our turtle. Do a little turtling, okay. I think I need to throw this one away. Turtly enough for the turtle club. There we go. There we go. I guess, do we want the lucky cards for the ducky, or do we want to make them lucky cards? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Why are the cards getting eaten? Because the ducks are hungry. Ducky, the rubber ducky is a mod joker. It's part of the extra credit joker pack. It's like the hiker, but it's the opposite. It steals the chips. Fool for a magician. Could take an heiress card and copy it with a fool. What's the turtle do? Turtle gets X-Molt every time you defeat a small or big blind. It's a scaling X-Molt joker. 0.2 molt. Slow and steady. We can take a hermit. Yeah, it's like madness, but it's slow. Madness is 0.5, turtle's 0.2. It's madness if it was a turtle. That's accurate. Yeah. Okay. Okay. I could take the seltzer. Seltzer, we could try to re-trigger the lucky cards for more money. We could do the star fruit. I can use the fool to copy death. Go next. All right, it's lucky time. We get the money for sure. Ship it. That's three. Yum. $60 reduce. Do a little re-rolling. Okay. Celestial pack. Eris. Wait, do we have a telescope? We do. Which means... Eris. Priestess. Alright. Do a little re-rolling. This boss says play only one hand. I think I can do that. I think. If we get the hand. We can spin the wheel. Holographic ducky. Dang, these rerolls are expensive. What's the plan with this run? We're trying to get some of the mod jokers. Specifically, we're looking for double rainbow, retrigger all lucky cards, and the warlock. When you play lucky cards, they get destroyed and they get turned into spectral cards. And the pocket aces. When you play aces, you get money. I want this. I want all of this. Also the forklift. Sounds like money. It do sound like that. I could see how you might think that that's how it sounds like, because that's correct. I'm gonna take the fool, I guess. Could take a baseball card here, since we have a bunch of uncommons. Baseball card instead of the seltzer, but the seltzer gives us money. We don't really need the Cardomancer because we have the Tarot Tycoon. Let's go next. Dang, get all these fives out of here. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ship it. Cardomancer stayed alive a little too long. We had room for it. We didn't have any reason to get rid of it until now. So I don't feel bad about holding on to it. It did the thing. Alright, this is what's gonna happen. We're gonna open this jumbo spectral pack and we're gonna get a red seal. We're gonna get a red seal, but there's not gonna be any aces. we could use Fool for an Heiress card, or we can save it. We could get a death card. We get a hung man. Let's do it. Avalio says double rainbow, potentially interesting. Only potentially interesting? Rude. Let's go purple ace. Yeah. Purple ace. Yeah. Yeah? Sure. Avalius lost a run. Weird Steam modded interaction. Okay. The mod loader doing weird stuff. All right, I think we're gonna hang him. We don't need strength. We can take another hermit. We can do death instead of the hung man is probably preferred. Let's go next. Aha. So copy the purple. Yeah. Ooh, do it again. Spin the wheel first. They're all foiled. Okay. Steel ace. Lucky money. Honokana gonna be lurking. Alright, good luck. Take care. I'll take care of Myrtle while you're gone. I promise to not murder her in the next two rounds. I don't make any promises beyond that. Did Seltzer skip the second card? The second card or whatever it was, it has no chips on it because of the duck. The duck takes all the chips, and then so that's why it seemed like it didn't trigger. Yeah. Hey, Freon. This is not Pokemon. No, not this time. This is the extra credit Joker pack created by the folks at Balatro University. Over a dozen and a half people working on the project. Do you want steel aces or lucky aces? Let's just go full on lucky. Game doesn't play the animations if you don't get the chips, but it still gets triggered, even if it doesn't animate. That makes sense to me. Avalios decided to download the Jokers and help out with the testing. If you do, all right, now you've got homework. Now you've got obligations. Now you got to give us feedback in the university Discord. Freon graduated from BalatroU. Did you now? What was your time on the Balatro University graduation gauntlet? How long did it take you? Did you complete the thesis project? One, two, three, four, five. Ship it. Wingcap checking the records. We don't have the documentation. Okay, Fool gives me Eris, or we can take the money. I think I want money. Borkium says, best tip for a new player or average player, an okay player, something that you wouldn't be able to figure out on your own. Well, maybe that's something that some people would be able to figure out on their own, is that maybe you shouldn't be skipping blinds. Maybe skipping is fatal a lot of the time. Maybe it's not worth it as much as you might think it is. I guess the main thing that people, I believe, okay, in my perception, the main thing that people take away from my content is just learning to play slower. So it's not any particular tip, like do this, don't do that. It's just learning to just take your time and be like, what are the different implications if I do this path or if I do this other thing? And try to be a little bit imaginative, a little bit creative. What could happen? And then decide the same thing that you were already going to do, but at least you thought about it. But I think another good takeaway is just learning about sandbagging. And so kind of every round trying to squeeze out as much value as you can from each round. It's not about scoring enough points to pass each round. It's about how many dollary dues you can get and how much plus mult you can stack on your bus and your green joker. It's about how long you can drag out every round. It's about power leveling, just like in an MMO. So then when you go fight the boss or whatever, you're over leveled. That's it. You know what? Let's spin the wheel. Ah, bummer. I make Balatro sound really boring when I put it like that. Well, you know, I didn't say it wasn't boring. Sometimes it just be like that. We could get a different source of chips. I gotta think about it. Spooky says, yeah, sandbagging kind of big, kind of important. Spooky's friends don't fully understand the value of min-maxing, sandbagging. How a couple extra dollars in the early game can kind of snowball into huge dividends later on. It's just better, the Eclipse? Well, I think what you mean is it's equally bad. Flush 5 currently gives us 1400 chips already, so we don't need this. Actually, baseball card times 1.5 molt on the ducky because it's an uncommon, so actually the ducky's better. And see, this is one of those things. You gotta stop, and you don't have to like think too hard about the numbers. You don't have to calculate it exactly, but just kind of eyeball it. It's okay to operate on just vibes, but maybe a little bit of thunking. Dolphin Lord says the Joker that sometimes has the potential for the most doesn't always have the most in the moment. Yeah, and kind of also the opposite. If there's something that seems like it's kind of not doing much right now, it could be doing more later if you work for it. I have the aces. I have too many face down cards. The dice are killing me. All right, 8 and 7, we can hang them. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Eternal Paradox says, wish it was easier to get the jokers that you're looking for. Two steps. This is two-step process. Number one, play on the Zodiac deck because you get overstock. Step two, don't take the Tarot Tycoon. You will get all of the tarot cards. You will build the perfect, most beautiful deck. You will be able to get nothing else but tarot cards. It's a gold seal. And we got the magician. We can get the money. And we got the Chad. I guess the Chad instead of the Seltzer. And we got Death. So, I could take a Fool card here, but man, probably the thing that you're supposed to do is copy the purple seals. I just want to make this gold seal into a lucky card. I want the forklift. I'll admit it. Right now, I want the forklift. Spin the wheel. Daniel is surprised that the seltzer hung around so long. I mean, the seltzer was re-triggering our lucky cards, and we have the sixes, so that was giving us an average of $4 per ace. It's not nothing. Spin the wheel again. Bummer. Got the gold seal. Give me magician one time. That's not a magician. Gold seal in front for the Chad. Mr. Guy wants to know my opinion on the turtle. Wait. There was a video with the turtle. You might have missed it. Definitely the turtle is in the thumbnail. Opinion on the turtle? The turtle is great. One of my favorites. The art is great. The ability, the effect is great. It's not overpowered. It's just right. Turtle's a cutie. Turtle. Friend shaped, for sure. I know some people say that ironically, but I do mean it. Friend shaped turtle. Actual turtle after which the art was modeled is also great. Great turtle. We can hang the queen, we can use death on the queen. We can take temperance, use death. Fool for another wheel? No. Fool for temperance, or we save the fool for death? I think we save fool for death. We could get a trading card. I think the ducky might have to go. It was a good time. It was a fun time. I think we've ascended. I think maybe it's not. I think we're gonna be doing different stuff now. I think we've, artistic differences, right? Double rainbow. Get that trading card out of here. All right, now we're cooking. All right. Okay. Spin the wheel. Go next. Purple seals. Hey, you know what'd be pretty cool right now? An idol. Do the kids still like the idol? I forgot where we landed on the idol. Gold seal. I need to make this lucky, and then if it's lucky, we can re-trigger with the rainbow. Gavin likes the idol. Okay, sure. Mr. Guy got it to work one time and has been trying to chase the dragon ever since. Ooh's back. Ooh, get in here. We got the double rainbow. And 2.2 on the Myrtle. And we got the dice. Okay. Could take a hungman. I could use strength on the blue seals finally. We could take the mail and rebate. Violet vessel. Magician, huge. Where is it? Where's the gold seal? Where is it? Anyone who doesn't already know this, the two booster packs, the two arcana packs, are mutually exclusive. So the first one shows you 8 cards from your deck, and the other one shows you a different 8 cards from your deck. So gold seal. Bang. Hermit? Sure. Yeah, you can use that if you if your deck is kind of small. If you got kind of a small deck, you can plan around that. Spin the wheel. Here's the thing. If it's a smaller deck, you get to know it more intimately. Do I have enough aces? Sorry, I meant do I have enough lucky cards? We do now. Okay. So, do we want the blue seals anymore? Rebate money? I can use death to copy the purple. More rebate money. Fool gives me another death card. We can spin the wheel for holographic. We can copy the gold seal here. Did you like that? Scrub of the year, did you like that? How about I don't need the justice card. I could play the pair of queens for the money. Okay. All of my cards are aces, so we discard these for the rebate. We can spin the wheel one more time. Foiled across the board. I can play 2 aces, I can draw 2 aces. Right? Ship it. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Retrigger the gold seals, retrigger the lucky cards. We got the dice here, it's 2 and 15. Ship it. Any better feeling when a lucky card gives you $20? Yeah, when a lucky card gives you $23. This run could have been pretty good with pocket aces. CC, here's the problem. CC, I'm the problem. It's me. I can't resist the Tarot Tycoon. That's the problem. You understand. Okay. Okay, as long as, you know, as long as you understand. Okay. We could get the forklift. We said we wouldn't murder. Sorry. We said we wouldn't murder, so. Okay. 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 Are the aces with no chips not triggering or getting skipped over? It doesn't animate because it doesn't have any chips, but it still triggers. It still triggers the lucky effect. The plus molten money and stuff like that. Or it attempts to trigger. Whoa. I have some awkward news. I think we might need to send Myrtle home. I think we might need to send Myrtle to the PC. Myrtle's going to Professor Oak. Telling Honu, Well, okay. We could get rid of the forklift, and then we won't be able to do as much purple seal action, but maybe that's okay. Chapin says, flip the turtle over. What the heck? That's rude as heck. It might even be illegal. Flip the turtle over. Okay. I can use the death card here. I can save the death card for the gold seals. Let's use them. We'll be playing cards now instead of throwing them. We could do both. It's Bartolomeo. All right. Can we? Okay. What's the thing called in Pokemon? It's like a wonder trade or something like that. Something trade. What's it called? Wonder trade? Yeah? Surprise trade? Okay. It's even got the same edition. Foiled again? Alright. We're trading the turtle for the rabbit. It's time. Honu, you're just in time. Honu, you're just in time. We got the aces, Honu. Aren't you happy we got the aces? We got the pocket aces. Look at this beautiful. We got the gold seals. We got the gold seal lucky cards. At what cost? We could take a magician. We can complete our collection. I'll be honest, I didn't get as many death cards as I wanted. Okay. So we discard the steel cards for sure. Okay. We discard these two purples and a six. Okay. We discard two more purple. Okay. Justice, I don't think we need. Okay, before we discard. So here's how, okay, if you don't know this, here's how Pocket Aces works. Okay. You get money at the end of the round for however many aces that you've played. This ante. So it keeps stacking up for the whole ante. If I play three aces this round, then I get $3 every round until the boss is over. If I play four aces next round, now it's $7 for two rounds. So we want to try to play as many aces as we can. But if we play four of a kind aces, does four of a kind aces win? Is that too many aces? That's what the question is. We do re-trigger lucky cards. So, ship it, right? I don't think we should go five. Five, it looks bad. So maybe we go four. Maybe it's not as hot if we go four. kind of busted moneymaker. So kind of the way that I think about this is, under normal conditions, I would say maybe you get on average, let's say, two aces per round under normal conditions. And so in the first round, you play two aces. Now you get $2 per round. In the second round, you play two more aces. You get $4 for that round. Against the boss, you play two more aces. You get $6 for that round. So it's kind of on average. So if it's two and then four and then six, it averages out to $4 per round. Which maybe is not that great, $4 per round, if you compare it to satellite, or if you compare it to, I don't know, gift card. If you compare it to, what else, Cloud9? Cloud9 just gives you the money if you have the nines in your deck, right? It's definitely not as strong as Cloud9, but it can become stronger with re-triggering effects, and I think that's kind of cool. Seems less busted than other money makers. Is it blueprint compatible? It's compatible with re-triggers, but it's not compatible with end of round. Blueprint does not copy end of round effects. Yeah, it's got a lot of potential, which is kind of cool. It tickles my brain a little bit. All right. I want to play four aces. I want to draw... Let's see, if I draw two queens and two aces, then we are fine. Chip. Cool that it triggers at end of round, so it doesn't synergize with interest. Oops. Dang it, Bartolomeo. Ah, beans. Crash thinks it should be a common. I think it's too complicated for a common. I like it at uncommon. Also, the ceiling is very high. Look, it's 20. It gave us $20 that round. It's going to give us $20 next round. Okay. We can't get ectoplasm. But we can still get a red seal. Could be fun. We can't spin the wheel anymore. We spun all our wheels. You know what we need? We need antimatter. That's what we need. Take a death card. Oh! It's the warlock! So we don't need the Chad. If we got double rainbow, re-triggers all the lucky cards, we don't need the Chad. Who needs the dice? But the dice, we get the money. The extra probability for the warlock. 2 in 7 chance on the warlock. See, I was telling you, I told you all we needed was the money, and this would be the run. We got the money, we got the overstock, we got all the jokers in anti-9, we got all of these this anti. Oh my goodness. Alright, so we go spectral pack for ectoplasm. Okay. Oh, wait. So the warlock, when you play lucky cards, it has a chance of destroying the lucky cards but replacing them with spectral cards. The warlock can give us ectoplasm. Yeah. We're not going to spin the wheel because we want to get ectoplasm on the warlock. I think this one we don't spin. Okay, so here's a Chad. There could be ectoplasm here. Grim. Bummer. I think the blue seals I think I am going to use death. You know what I need? And this is going to sound controversial. I need the magic trick voucher. Magic trick so we can add extra cards for the warlock. Because the warlock destroys your cards. Dang, Wingcap said that Wingcap was thinking the same thing. Wingcap, you've been around this rotisserie once or twice. Hey, Jamie, thank you for the 4 months. Jamie, we got 3.75 on Bartolomeo. Okay. Okay. Queen, I can turn into a gold ace. No hung man. I can make the fives lucky and we can delete them if they're lucky. Honu says the ship of Theseus would go hard here. Honu, no spoilers. They don't know about the ship of Theseus yet. We could get a blue joker. Alright, here's the thing. Okay. Pocket aces only gives us money. Blueprint is better than dice. Quadruple rainbow. Okay, but we're gonna get the dice back. No, the dice comes back. Yeah. Oh! Quadruple rainbow. Oh, we could do this too. Okay, so the way this works is if you copy the rainbow here and you get the retrigger on the lucky cards, it makes this trigger more times. It rerolls more times per card. If you do this, when the one card gets destroyed, you get two spectral cards this way. So probably we do it this way. All right, let's go next. I love her, the warlock. Let's go gold seal ace. So play the fives. I'm going to copy the rainbow, re-trigger so we get to grow Bartolomeo if we ship it. Okay, we can discard purple. That was uneventful. Well, sometimes it'd be like that. Okay, we can play. How many aces can we get away with? Can we get away with 3 aces? We want to play a lot of aces for the pocket aces. Let's play 3 aces. Let's play these aces because they don't have the gold seals. Then they might get destroyed. Okay. Let's play these aces. 5. Ship it. Okay, so $44 from the pocket aces. You still think pocket aces should be a common? I don't know. I'm not convinced. Seems all right. Warlock is going to cause some issues. Are you concerned about how small my deck is getting? It's okay, I'm used to it. We could take a gold seal queen. I guess I could take a blue seal. Never seen the dollar signs wrap around like that before. Hey look, Cloud 9. It's almost like Pocket Aces. It gives us money at the end of the round. Do we want to save our money for after we get ectoplasm? We could do ectoplasm first. Currently I'm rerolling for death, maybe. Purple seal, gold seal. I like the gold seals. I could also do a red seal. Copy the red seal. And then fool. Okay. I could take a magician. The boss is extra large. Okay. This queen, I could use the magician. I could just use a death card. Maybe death card is easier. All right. There's another death card for this five. Okay. Let's play three aces. Delete. Let's discard two purple. We can play these three aces. Are you thunking what I'm thunking? For folks who don't know this interaction, so double rainbow re-triggers the lucky cards. It doesn't re-trigger the lucky effect, it re-triggers the whole card. So if the card is polychrome, it'll re-trigger the polychrome. Oh, dang it, Bobby. Oh. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's a 1 out of 6. Yeah, it's 1 out of 6. 1 out of 6 is not terrible odds. We keep the polychrome one for later. Okay. Bartolomeo, ship it. Cool. We got the forklift. Look, we got the forklift voucher. Extra consumable slot. Okay. Hex doesn't work here. Hex would give us polychrome, but it destroys your jokers. Maybe we need a voucher skip. All right. Currently, I'm looking for death. Okay. Give me death. Give me a fool. Don't need the magician. If I found the idol, would I take it? I would. Yeah. What about DNA? Okay, so the pocket aces gives us $100 per round or whatever it is, but what if we do DNA with the warlock? The pocket aces can come back around. We can do the pocket aces again after we change it to a common. We did the aces. Didn't you see we did the aces? Pocket aces is the point of the run? Says who? No, we'll get ectoplasm. It'll come back around. Okay. We got science levels of money. It'll come back around. This boss is stinky. That's okay. We got the big boy payment. Yeah. So I want to copy polychrome. So before we do that, let's copy the red seal. Nah. Just ship them. Okay, now we can go death, fool, death, I think. There is a six in the deck. I could try to dig for the six. Copy the polychrome. Tempting. Okay. Death. Rare pass on Emily. Hashtag rare. Discard three purples. It's an imposter. No, it's me. It's really me. No. All right. Retrigger the lucky cards. Play five. And then we have five more. Ship it. I guess like that. Okay. Times nine on Bartolomeo. Okay. I got a question. Never mind, I figured it out. All right, let's take an heiress card. Hello, Zeno, welcome back. Zeno, we got the double-double rainbow. We got the daily double. Times nine on Bartolomeo. Yeah, and we got the rainbow aces. Look at that. Got the rainbow aces. Hey, it's Zeno. Zeno from the Balatro. One rainbow away from, look. See, Adrizzle, I told you the pocket aces, I told you it would come back around. If we, so we could, I said I would take it. Okay. So, bye bye warlock? No, I still want my ectoplasm. Better than cat, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. It's time 64. No. You get to re-trigger the idol because you re-trigger the lucky cards. Well, it's, yeah, it's like times 1,000 or something like that. It's a whole order of magnitude. It's a whole ordeal. we can make a red ace. We can make a shiny ace. We can skip the rest. Warlock is very exciting. I agree. I'm pretty sure the idol comes back around. I'm gonna do this. There we go. So we could discard the purple seals. That's an option. You can always discard the purple seals. Or we could play a couple aces, maybe four aces, maybe three aces. Again. Okay. Okay. Play another three aces. Wait, I didn't get that many. Where's all my agains? What the heck? Alright, discard three purples. Fool for another hermit? I can discard like this. Hermit and temperance. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ship it. Incantation. Wait. Incantation. And Grim. Okay. Okay, I understand. We can rebuild him. Okay. Boss is no discards though, so that's kind of annoying. I can use death. Okay, so we go incantation first, grim second, death last. Fool on the death card. Now we have 26. I gotta say, this whole deleting the cards is wildly fun. I need a magician. Whose idea was this? Who are we blaming for this? See, I told you it would come back around. I just want a magician. Where'd a magician at? Eris and then Temperance. Daniel can't do this anymore. Daniel, their heart can't take it. All right, let's go next. Stinky, unlucky. All right, this ace. Okay, so now that we have the idol, I don't think we can play that many aces, right? Like if I play two aces. Bummer. No discards. Beans. We'll get them next time. Idol says Ace of Diamonds. Okay. So, let's crack open the Arcana pack. We can use one death card. Okay. Do I want a magician? I don't need a magician. Death is fine. Death is enough. Let's go next. So death here and dig. I should discard all the polychrome ones. Hermit's okay. Death here. Discard three and some polychromes. Okay, didn't get death, that's okay. Discard purple one. Okay, so presumably, I think we can play two now, but I think I'm gonna play five so that we can try to trigger the warlock. You know what we could do? Never mind. Ship it. Aura. Avalios, we might be going, I don't know if it's endless, but we are gonna go for a little while, I think. All right, team, I got news. I got pee real bad. I'll be right back. We'll be back in, just give me a minute. I'm gonna get some water too. All right, folks, welcome back. All right, team, here's how it goes. We have 52 minutes left. In 52 minutes, my wife is gonna come home with Bojangles. And when the Bojangles come home, that's it, it's over. All right, let's get cooking. All right, we can use the red seal on maybe nothing, actually. We only got 23 cards left. We can use a fool for a death card. I see the poll in the chat. Coleslaw haters unite. Coleslaw haters stand up, rise up. Stand with me. Oh, I should have done this. Actually, hold on. The mod loader, Steam modded, it starts to lag after like an hour. So, hold on. How refreshing. A fool. It's kind of funny that the warlock kind of turns all of our cards into glass. We got the glass card build. Spooky says the poll is closer than you thought for the coleslaw. Do we hate it? Do we love it? It's closer than I was expecting too. What's up with that? All right, discard some purple cards. Maybe we should make more purple cards, actually. Maybe we're running out of purple ones. We can discard two at a time. Fool for Temperance. You know what? Fine. We can get rid of the death card, I guess. Play all the shiny aces. Alright, blueprint, brainstorm, double rainbow. Ship it. Alright, can I just say, you know what else I love about the warlock is this. It refills itself. It refills your deck. It's so good. We get another ace here. Okay. I can take a 9. So, Sigil's out. I can take a Magician to go with my Aces with Grimm. Okay. So, what's the boss gonna do to me? First hand face down. That's rude. I don't have the boss reroll. Well, Fiddlesticks. I think it's fine. Yeah. Let's go next. So against this boss, you go Grim. Hey, look at that. They're both diamonds. Wow. Okay. And then Cryptid? Wow. Okay, so that means this one's purple. Okay. That's the deck. Wait a second. I thought I had a card that was not an ace. Did the non-ace get deleted? What the heck? Oh, we used death on it? Did I? I'll believe you. Ship it? Incantation! That's plus four! I killed that card with my two hands. My own hands. Alright. Deja Vu's out. Incantation. So now I need... Could take a magic trick? We did it. We got the magic trick. It's time. It's time for magic. So, I think I'm not gonna do incantation. I think maybe incantation is a little bit too spooky for me. But with the magic trick voucher, hey Chip. Times 20 on Bartolomeo. I could take this ace. Let's see. Fool. Hermit. Hermit. Emperor? Yeah, I think incantation is not going to be it because we have the idol. You know, I don't want to be too rambunctious here. I can take a magician. I can take death. I can take... I actually want a... I need diamonds, so I need a star card. I could add an ace. Where's the star? There's a star. Go next. So, start by discarding. Discard again. These two aces I want to turn into diamonds. This seven, let's make it purple. And then we have an extra fool. So I guess we can make this one into a lucky card. We can discard. We get a fool for a death card, okay. So we do another purple. Discard two. Fool for another death card. Spooky, big fan of Popeyes. Popeyes is all right. Popeyes was my favorite until I discovered Bojangles, and then that's it, it's over. Here's the thing, Spooky. Popeye's got a weak chicken tender. I know that's not what everyone goes there for. You know, they get the bone-in chicken or whatever, but they got tenders on the menu. Their tenders are weak. And it's not that... I think they're okay seasoned, okay? But there's not enough chicken for how much breading is on there, and the breading is hard. You know, sometimes you get a crispy chicken, sometimes you get a crunchy chicken. The Popeyes breading on their tenders is hard. All right, I think we can play. I think the idol will allow us to play a pair here. Maestro says Bojangles is the only fast food ever to make you violently ill. Well, it's going to be different from region to region, location to location. I'm sorry you had that experience. It is a chain, so that stinks, man. Oh! So what's it gonna be? Blueprint, Brainstorm, Warlock. We could get rid of the Warlock, but it would be fun to get another Ectoplasm. Oh, look at that. Look at that beauty. All right. Okay. Let's not play the polychrome ones. No, we could play the poly. Well, ship it. We could get another gold seal. It's been a while since we had a gold seal. Spooky makes some mean chicken tenders. That's great. All right, Spooky. I'll tell you, you know, next time I'm in Pittsburgh. Eris. We can take the Marvel Joker and we can copy it. Look. We could copy the Marvel Joker. Oh, baby. Because the Marvel Joker doesn't affect the idol. We have defense against the dark arts. What are we shopping for? We're shopping for death. We're shopping for maybe Myrtle. Maybe a showman. If only we could go back in time. We went back in time once. We could go back in time again. If the opportunity presents itself. What was the boss again? The boss is spades. Okay. There's a mime we don't need. So I've got death, I've got fool. What is the follow-up? What's the additional card that I want? We could take the rebate money. Instead of the Marble Joker. I guess that's... Okay. If we get the rebate... Then we can do a little bit more re-rolling. I only have 21 cards in the deck. I don't got this many cards for the rebate. The rebate will come back. We'll do the rebate later. Crash, is this what you want? You want the aces? Ace in the hole? So, are you telling me that pocket aces, money for aces, this is going to be better than mail-in rebate? Alright. Alright. Okay. pick up an 8. I need one more card. I missed. Go next, I guess. Okay. So basically we just dig until we get that 8 so we can use death on it. Okay. 2 aces. 2 aces this way. That's gonna be $10. Okay. That's gonna be 23 on Bartolomeo. Okay. We could do 2 aces this way. We can do 5 aces. We can discard 2 purple first. All right, those things don't matter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ship it. Spooky did some culinary training back in 2020. That's awesome. $49 from the first round. Does that mean we're gonna get another $49 after the boss? Sus. All right, I want to add 2 cards. I want to add a queen and I want to get a death card. Resets the payout on the boss blind. So wait, do I get the payout or do I not get the payout? Zano says it's going to be a surprise. Wait. After the payout is the reset. Oh. Ah, I see. The message has 2 parts. I see. Hey, that's kind of cute. Reading is hard. Yeah, even with these glasses. I forgot I'm trying to add a second card to my deck. There we go. We added a second card to the deck. So I can go cryptid on the purple one. I want to find a star card. Let's find a star card. There's a star card. That's not what I meant. Come on, don't be like that. There's the star. All right, let's go next. Drizzle knows an actual gay Chad. This ace I wanted to make into diamonds and then throw it away. This queen I want to turn into an ace and then use the fool. I want to dig for the six by discarding once. All right, we're out of aces. So now we can play two. Get a cryptid, get an immolate. So those two aces are gone, but we can make two more. Okay. Play two more aces. Zeno's an anarchist. He wants us to burn them all down. Zeno, we're bleeding out here. We only got 22 aces left. Big money. Wait, it just says 100. I wanted the dollar reduce to just wrap around. 100. We did it. We did it. Okay, buffoon pack. We can get the rough gem and then we can re-trigger all of the lucky cards. Sorry, Ford asks, what's the build? You know what? Now is a great time. This is a great time. If you got ads, let me know you got ads and then I'll repeat it. But here's the build. We've got double rainbow says re-trigger all lucky cards. Okay. And then we can copy it with blueprint. We can copy it with brainstorm. So we're going to re-trigger all the cards. What are the cards that we're re-triggering? We're re-triggering polychrome aces, aces of diamonds. Aces, we have the idol. So we get times two molt. So it's kind of like if you've done idol and sock and buskin, or you've done idol and hack, it's kind of like that. The only difference is these are also lucky cards, which give us money. We've got Bartolomeo here. So times 30 on the cat, because we've got so many lucky cards. And we have another new joker, the Warlock. Warlock gives us our lucky cards have a chance of being destroyed. And when they get destroyed, they get replaced with spectral cards. Oh wait, you got the ads? It's too late. Already started the lecture. Now we'll just repeat it in 40 seconds. That's my bad. Stupid helped with the idea for Warlock. Came up with the card destruction idea. Yeah, Stupid knows his stuff. He's a man of the people. He knows what the people want. And the people is me. All right, I think the ads are over now. Forward, are you back? I was waiting for you. Well, I wasn't originally waiting for you, but then I was waiting for you. Stupid also helped code the Warlock because the destruction effect was really complicated. Okay, Possessed is back. Everyone's back. Okay. So here's a quick rundown. Double rainbow retriggers all the lucky cards. Blueprint brainstorm copies double rainbow, so we get more retriggers. This retriggers not just the lucky card effect, but the whole card. So if the card is polychrome, if the card is, we've got the idle times two on aces. So these two combined, idle and then double rainbow, is kind of like idle with sock and buskin, idle with hack. We have the cat times 30 on the cat because we are triggering all of the lucky cards. We've also got, here's a new joker. Well, I guess double rainbow and then also warlock. These are both from the Balatro University extra credit joker pack. These 15 jokers. So the way the warlock works, when you play your lucky cards, they have a chance to be destroyed. And then when they get destroyed, they get replaced with spectral cards. So what we've been doing is we've been trying to get ectoplasm so we can get negative jokers. We got one ectoplasm, one negative. Where is it? Not this one. This one actually just showed up in the shop. Warlock became negative. But that's basically it. We're doing the aces. We got the red seal aces, polychrome aces. I do need to figure out every round. I need to figure out how to refill the deck because Warlock does destroy the aces. So, hey, would you look at that? Okay. I need you to hear me out. I need you to hear me out, okay? So, Rough Gem gives us a dollar on every ace activation. Or, plus two consumable slots. This works for purple seals and works for tarot cards. So we could take a magician here. Five consumable slots, it's so over. Oh yeah, I didn't mention this one. We also have the pocket aces. Pocket aces gives us money when we play aces. Are these the tarot cards that I want? I think so. Would anyone have argued in favor of Rough Gem? I would have. If you would have let me, I would have. Hey, look, he's doing a little dance. You know, when I look at this, when I look at Forklift, it looks like Jimbo's about to crash into something. It looks like he's about to do something irresponsible. Does anyone else get that vibe? I'm gonna play the two aces because I have room for two aces. Definitely not a bandicoot, says his name is also Crash. You know, here's something I noticed with the warlock. A single card can trigger multiple spectral cards without being destroyed, only the one destruction, right? So if you play one card, it could possibly trigger two spectral cards with one destruction. And I think that's neat. I don't know if that's intentional, but I think that's neat. Intended design! Ship it? Cryptid? You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna make some gold seals. We're gonna do it for the money. And then we're gonna discard five. We don't need the polychrome ones. Alright. I wanna draw my queen. We got the queen. We can use gold seal. I want to use the star on the other ace. So we can discard three purples. I get a death card. Well, that makes things easier. Because I can make these lucky, but then I can just use death. All right, discard the purple. One, two, three, four, five. Gold seals, re-trigger. Fire in the hole. Also, we got this, pocket aces. We get $45 dues at the end of the round, assuming that we survive. Avalios wants to see oops, all sixes. $58 cash out. Okay. You know, here I'm thinking, you know when we did the Cloud Nine and we got the big Cloud Nine and we got like hundreds of dollars payout on the Cloud Nine? I feel like even though this is giving us $50 right now, I feel like we've made more than 100 aces. Is that true? Have we made that many aces? Update on the cat, now times 3. 33.2. I don't know why it says 0.2 instead of 0.25. It's a rounding error. And not the fun kind of rounding error. Let's take a stone card. Okay, I said I wanted... Where is it? The magic trick? I actually want illusion so I can get stone cards in the shop. There's nothing in the Arcana pack that I really care about. Okay. If we have the tower, we can take a 3 and then turn it into stone. We can take a 7 and reroll for a death card. Okay, so I have a 3 and a 7. I'm not going to take the 10 yet until I know... Hey look, it's the Eclipse. Plus 12 chips for every hand level. 768. Genevieve wants to know how big can we make the pocket aces. Currently a problem that we have is we score too many points and we don't actually get to play that many aces. I would like to get a voucher where I get an extra hand. It's actually not that big. Yeah, we just have the level up flush 5 but not really anything else. Can take a magician. I could take a king and then pick up a strength card. Where's the strength card? Dang. There's a strength card. Okay, so we got strength, we got death, we got tower. Okay, so I go strength on the king, tower on the 7, death on the 3. Now we just need a fool. Boxy wants to know how many tarot cards are there. There's 22 tarot cards. So if I open this Arcana pack... There's not that many left. Take a temperance here. Can't guarantee certain tarot cards, but we can get pretty close. which I think is neat. So, do we want the showman? Showman would allow us to get another blueprint or brainstorm or double rainbow, but we'd have to get rid of the pocket aces. I guess we could get rid of the forklift, but the forklift kind of, we want it for the warlock. Double forklift. Oh, double forklift. Man, the aces have been so disrespected all night. Wait a second. If we got the showman, we could just pick up death cards. We could just roll them. Wait a second. Wait, Boxy, this is huge. Wait. Wait a second. Yeah, Drizzle, if the aces wanted to hang out, they should have showed up earlier, okay? Forklift kind of cozy, okay. I can take an emperor, or let's just go next. So the three we turn into purple. We could probably don't need the magician. We can play two aces. Alright, Ankh and Familiar, we don't need. We can play two Gold Seal aces. Oh, I love that noise. Okay. This king, I said I would use my strength. Okay. This seven, I'm going to stone. That way we can discard. Let's make the gold seal. Okay. We can discard two purple and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ship it. Times 36 on Bartolomeo. Oh yeah. The showman can do that sometimes. All right, team, what's on the menu? What are we eating? Audrizzle wants to know, can we afford two ectoplasms? Absolutely not. There's no way. This is minus two, this is minus three. There's no way. Wait, maybe if we had DNA? Anyway, we could take the Chad. I'm gonna be slightly conservative. I'm gonna be slightly patient. Okay, very thoughtful, very demure. Okay. Let's get rid of the second ectoplasm so no one gets tempted. Okay, we could take the dice. Okay, currently Currently, our hand size is 7. Minus 2 takes us down to 5. The boss is minus 1 hand size. So, can we beat this boss with 4 of a kind instead of a flush 5? What do you think? I think we don't need the forklift anymore. As fun as it has been, I think we don't need the forklift anymore. If we copy the idol, we can beat this boss. Forklift plus showman is bad. No, forklift plus showman is good, because then we can hold on to 5 death cards at a time. I think I'm not going to take the 6s yet. I think I'm going to go for something a little bit more ambitious. Queen? Sure. Save ectoplasm until after the boss? That's an option, yeah. So, take a hermit. Take another hermit. Hold on to a death card. We could get a Weasible Joker. Now that is tempting. That's a I messed up. Oops. Crash wants to see negative forklift. Okay. So, goodbye, Chip. Death, and I need a fool. Looking for a fool. Tower is okay. Emperor. There's a fool. I go next. Let's battle. This 7, I can. Let's use death. And we can play 2. I don't even know what I want from the Warlock, actually, if we already have ectoplasm. Maybe we don't need to feed the Warlock anymore. I mean, like, we could still do it a little bit, but maybe we don't need to go super hard. More Grim for more aces? Yeah, but I don't know. Okay, death here. Fool, I can copy death, or I'm gonna copy the temperance. Warlock is eating the aces. Yeah, but what I mean is I don't have to play a pair here, because if I play the pair, the aces get eaten. We're going to keep the Warlock. What I mean is I don't need to play extra into the Warlock. Ship it. We only deleted one card, but we got two spectral cards. Crash, you're sad that we got rid of the pocket aces? Yeah, but now we got an extra joker slot, so it'll come back around. Okay. The ducky's back. All of our aces, by the way, all of our aces have no chips. Because somebody got a little hungry, got a little snacky. Mime. We gotta wait one more round for the invisible joker. Okay. We can take a jack. We can take two jacks. Death and a fool. No fool yet. Star, no. Could take a tower. There's the fool. Okay, all we gotta do is go one more round. I want to make a purple seal. We should just go purple seals because we have the forklift. Wonder what invisible joker will hit. We could start a poll. We could make some quick cash. So, discard four purple seals for the forklift. CC's on it. Sorry, no. Adrizzle's on it. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How are we doing on polychrome, by the way? Are we running out? We're actually kind of running out of polychrome. So, here's something I was kind of curious about. Okay, we got times 39 on Bartolomeo. Obviously, if you go Blueprint and Brainstorm on the Rainbow, you get the most lucky activations. But maybe we actually don't want that many lucky activations because the extra lucky activations trigger the Warlock. So maybe we want more idle activations for more points. So if I do this, idle, 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 that's three idols, double rainbow, and the red seals, this should be actually optimal. Alright, we've got trading card. Okay, trading card's out. There you go. I got you. Adrizzle, I got you. Boxy's going all in on the forklift. Okay. I can take an 8, I can take Arcana packs. Chariot, nope. Possessed Hood is all in. I can use death. Let's make more polychrome aces. Okay. So we can get an emperor. We get death. There's the sixes. All right. It's time. Ah, bummer. People want the forklift. It wasn't meant to be. Ah, bummer. Rats. So we could take the sixes, and then we could re-trigger the lucky cards for Bartolomeo. You want to get Big Cat? We can get Big Cat. Ectoplasm? Ah. We got the dirty napkin. Nah. Never lucky. Invisible Joker number two, maybe? So, I need a fool card. So, Emperor. Spin the wheel? Dang, get real unlucky on the wheels. All right, we got the fool. Let's go next. Uh-oh, wait. My hands are so tiny. Need a paintbrush. Yeah. How am I supposed to hold all these limes? Do we have a paintbrush yet? Not at all. Not even one hand size. You know what? We can make this ace lucky. Look at that. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, so the optimal scoring configuration is like this. So now we've got two rainbows. We've got three idols. Times 40, ship it. Now times 42. Got a cryptid. They're all gone. The oops all sixes, it raises the probability to 2 out of 7. Light them up. They're all gone. All right, well, you know, now we just do the thing, I guess. I kind of want a star card. So I'm not gonna do familiar, I'm not gonna do talisman. I can take a magician and a star. Hey, we got the four fieners. There's a fool looking for a death card. Boxy, that's not the natural negative that you were looking for. Exactly what we needed. We got 680 bucks. Do a little re-rolling. We got the spooky hand. I don't have room for temperance unless I make room. Expel Sword says we could play a flush five with an ace of spades in there. We can sneak in different flavored aces because of the four feigners. That's true. If our cards were kings instead of aces, Kania would be crazy here. Yeah. That would be fun. We could get DNA. We possibly replace the dice. The dice come back. The green fingies possibly infected. It's Chip, he's back. All right. I think I've decided. Boxy. Not like this. No, not like this. Forky. And now we're broke. Hey, look, we can get Fibonacci. It's over for the believers. So we can go Grim. We can go Diamonds. This one's already lucky. Okay, we can go Cryptid. I could use Death here. I guess I don't have to use Death here. We could discard. Look at that. If we didn't have the showman, we wouldn't have the double barrel death cards. It's beautiful. Alright, so we're gonna copy the DNA. Ship it. That's it. We can do one more. We can copy the double rainbow, retrigger the lucky cards for the money. We have ectoplasm number 3. All right, let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 43 on Bartolomeo. This is all of the polychrome cards. Let's go Idle there. So Idle with two brainstorms, and then we've got, this is best. All right, two rainbows, three idols. Ship it. Hey, wait a gosh darn second. We got no money on that hand. All right, folks. That's gonna be it for me. We did what we set out to do. We got to play with the double rainbow here. We trigger all the lucky cards. We got to play with the warlock. We got to delete some lucky cards. We got to make some spectral cards. We got to make some more lucky cards. We got Bartolomeo here. We did the lucky cat. Idle helped out. Idle helped out in the late game. We did for a little while. Got to do the pocket aces. Pocket aces gives you money for aces. Pocket aces is really terrible. It's really bad. But under the right conditions, it could be kind of okay. You just got to get enough re-triggers. What I like about this is Sock and Buskin doesn't interact with this, and Hack doesn't interact with this. You really got to go out of your way to re-trigger aces. Crash says, pocket aces common? Absolutely not. No way.